Kiss. 9:25 Monday morning, Bernie and Sid. Shout out to my friend Rule. He owns the Portofino's Tanning Salon. A bunch of them all over the city. Never misses this show, ever. 9 o'clock every morning, Rule gets in his car and puts on Bernie and Sid. So, we love you, Rule. We love Portofino Tanning Salon.
Yes, we do.
Paul Stanley is vocalist, lead guitarist, big guy, right-hand man. Gene Simmons, part of that great group, Ace Frehley. God, I used to love these guys. I really did. Peter, Chris.
The best.
Kiss. Paul Stanley's got another book coming out. It's on sale tomorrow. Backstage Pass. His first book, Face the Music, was a New York Times best-selling memoir. This is going to be also an inspirational look at his life, and he'll be very, very reflective here, share some lessons he's learned. He's a very bright guy, and of course, a wonderful musician making his debut after three appearances here by Gene Simmons. We finally get the real talent in the band, Paul Stanley. Good morning, Paul.
I love, you know, I should just let you go on. That was so good.
Thank you.
Going.
Thank you. Jim Carr's not going to do that. I'll tell you that right now.
Trust me, he's very good at that.
Now, listen, before we get to the rock and roll stuff, being that you were born Stanley Eisen, born about 20 blocks north of where I live right now on the Upper West Side, and you're a proud Jewish guy, your sister, your parents both Jewish, I don't know, Paul, if we should talk about rock and roll or what happened in San Diego on Saturday, the New York Times cartoon, the anti-Semitism that is enveloping America. Are you keeping up with that? Does that make you sick?
Well, how could we not keep up with what's going on in the world? It's sobering and certainly a time for reflection and trying to figure out what the hell's going on. So, this is a time where perhaps there's no easy answers, but we need to have some. So on another note, I have to tell you that growing up, WABC was the rock and roll station
that played
the home of Herb Oscar Anderson, who was one of the big DJs, and he had a theme song, and WABC was in competition with WMCA, and those were your rock and roll stations.
Dan Ingram and Cousin Brucey. That's right.
Bruce Morrow, and you had Herb Oscar Anderson, and you had all the B. Mitchell Reed was on WMCA. But anyway, I'm dating myself, and nobody wants to hear this anymore.
No, that's good stuff. I mean, you could have started with, like, WNEW with Scott Muni and Carol Miller and those guys, because I know you love those guys, too.
Well, but that came later, actually started with WOR-FM, which was really your first free-form radio station in New York, playing all kinds of progressive music, and it was before they had DJs, and WNEW was
right there. That came later. So when you were growing up watching rock and roll on TV, Paul, was it the Beatles? Was it the Rolling Stones? Who were the bands, if not the band, that really got you inspired?
Well, I grew up and I was lucky. I was in a household where we listened to lots of music. My mom was born in Germany and my dad was first generation from Poland. And in Europe, music and art is like having breakfast. It's part of your day. It's part of your diet. So I grew up in a house where we listened to classical music and opera and show tunes, and I brought in rock and roll. I would watch American Bandstand and watch Alan Freed, who coined the phrase rock and roll. And I would see everybody from Eddie Cochran to Dion and the Belmonts and all these people. While everybody else was out, all the other kids were playing Cowboys and Indians. You know, at 6 years old, I was home listening to rock and roll. So it started there. But surely when the Beatles came along, that was pivotal. That was life-changing. And it not only changed music, but it impacted society. That's what phenomenons do.
You know, we had Gene Simmons in studio here about two or three times, to be honest with you. And quite honestly, he could be a long day. You know that. But you know that you've been the driving force behind Kiss. Everybody knows that. So how long have you been tired of Gene Simmons grabbing all the attention?
Well, you know, we're all different, and Gene really is family to me. Gene is my brother, and we've traveled this road from literally living in our parents' houses to where we are today, and we couldn't have done it without each other. And I don't agree with some of the things he says or does, but that's family. How that goes.
Yeah. True. Oh, no doubt.
Blessed.
But listen, you're a great story, and Gene is too. We love Gene. Gene, like you said, we've been here two or three times. We got to get Ace on, and we'll do the whole band thing. But you're a great story, Paul, in that you were born with an ear issue, something with your face. You have now got your own charity for many years. It's about face. So you really had some obstacles that you had to overcome. Maybe that's part of the reason why you've got that star over your eye. I don't know. But you've overcome some real big obstacles to become the rock star that you are today.
Well, everybody overcomes obstacles. And what I've tried to do, both in my first book, Face the Music, and my new one, Backstage Pass, is really peel away all the mystique, because the less secrets I have, the more other people can relate and say, wow, we're not all very different. And what I've tried to do with Backstage Pass, the new book, is really say to people, look, it's easy to find well-intentioned people around you who are going to tell you, hey, if I were you, I would, and then you fill in the blank right. when you have a problem. But I'm here, you know, to say, listen, that's absurd, because nobody is you. Nobody's lived your life. So what I'm trying to do with my books is say, this is how I lived, and this is how I dealt with certain issues, and maybe you can get some insight or get some inspiration for your life. So it's almost leading by example as opposed to telling people how they should live. I'm in no position to tell anybody else how to live, but I can certainly tell you how I did it and have been quite successful.
Indeed. The book is Backstage Pass. Our guest is Paul Stanley from KISS on 77 WABC on the Bernie and Sid Show. Paul, let me ask you this question. One of your signature songs, of course, is I Want to Rock and Roll All Night, Party All Day Long. Gene Simmons, clean and sober all his life, ironically. And how about yourself?
Well, I love a good glass of wine, and I love some alcohol time to time. And the whole idea, really, in that song, because I wrote, you know, I Want to Rock and Roll All Night and Party Every Day.
See what I mean?
You know,
you were the driving force.
Well, partying, when I was writing it, naive or not, was really about celebrating. And it wasn't about getting high or getting stoned or anything like that. It was, I want to rock and roll all night and party every day. I want to have a great time and make the most of life. And that's really what both my point of view and KISS's point of view has always been, is to celebrate life and to make the most of life, because as far as I know, we don't get a second chance.
No.
So this is our bite at the apple. So make the most of your life.
On the way out, I'm a huge KISS fan, huge. Christine, 16, all of it. I loved all your albums. And when I was a kid, you were my favorite band. But like other people will say, well, part of the reason why they do all the makeup and the star kid and the tongue with Gene Simmons and all that other stuff was to make up for the fact that they really were not a great band. Well, wait a second. You guys made the Hall of Fame in 2014. You, Paul, you're one of the most established and well-respected guitarist lead singers ever. So when I hear that, I do laugh. But you know that is out there.
Well, look, life's really barely long enough to deal with the people who like what you do, let alone try to make converts of the ones who don't. So I think my track record speaks for itself. It's going on 50 years, and a novelty will certainly get you attention, but it won't last that long. You know, there has been enough fads that come and go, but KISS has stood the test of time, and you don't sell 100 million albums on makeup. It just doesn't work like that. So I'm totally proud of what we've done. I'll stand toe-to-toe with any other band.
No doubt. Well, the book is out tomorrow, Backstage Pass, Paul Stanley from the great band KISS. And so order it on Amazon.com. Anyway, Paul, listen, it is a pleasure to talk to you. One day we'll see you in studio, I hope.
You betcha. Next time in the studio.
That'd be great, Paul. Thank you. Paul, by the way, is also in the Long Island Hall of Fame for music. So he is Mr. New York, no doubt about it. And really, in all seriousness, one of the all-time greats. Go buy his book tomorrow, Backstage Pass, and here's some Kiss on the way out.
I wanna rock it.